Good morning, 6th class. Now topic number 2, properties of materials. We have total 5 properties mentioned in your book, and the name of the properties are appearance, hardness, soluble, insoluble in water, then objects may float or sink in water, and then transparency. So here number first is appearance. Appearance means how it looks, kis tarike ka dikhta hai. And here wood is different from iron, iron is different from copper, aluminium. Just look here, this pen is of different shape and size, laptop is of different shape and size, even one person is different from other person. So appearance means how it looks. Then topic number 2 is luster and dull. Luster means if the material is shining. Dull means if there is no shining. Luster examples are iron, copper, aluminium, gold. And dull example is wood. And so many like pen. Pen is also dull. There is no shining. Suppose if there is metal and it is dull. Okay, then what you have to do to test whether it is shining or not, cut that metal surface. On the newly cut surface, you will observe a shiny appearance. So this is known as luster. Even on the upper surface is appearing dull, but if you cut it, it appears shiny. Then our next one is hardness. Hardness is हार्डनेस इज नंबर सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी. अपियरेंस के अंदर ही आपके पास दोनों आ रहा था, लास्टर एंड डल. नाउ सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी इज हार्डनेस. एज यू आर ऑब्जर्विंग दिस पेन इज हार्ड. एंड वॉट यू कैन आई शो यू हियर, कॉटन इज सॉफ्ट, विच यू कैन कंप्रेस, जस्ट हियर कंप्रेस्ड, सो इट इज सॉफ्ट. बट इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू कंप्रेस, यू कैन नॉट फोल्ड दिस पेन, सो इट इज हार्ड. एंड हियर इन द फिगर यू आर ऑब्जर्विंग टू हैंड्स, अपर एंड लोअर हैंड्स, एंड देन टॉर्च. ऑल दीज थ्री आर you cannot compress them, so they are in the category of hardness. Now look here the definition. Soft means materials which you can compress. Hard means difficult to compress. Examples are cotton and sponge, and here example is iron. Now property number third is soluble, insoluble. So here we have one glass, just glass filled with water, and what I'm showing here is soluble, insoluble. Here I have salt put here, and then it is soluble. As you are observing that there is no molecule of salt, so that means the salt is soluble. Observe here, there is no salt, so it is soluble. And here this is the pen of a sketch cover, so just put here. It is not dissolving in water, so cover of a sketch is in the category of insoluble, and salt is soluble in water. Then next we have here definitions. Definition is soluble means completely dissolve, example sugar and salt. Insoluble means do not mix with water, example stone and nail. Then next is objects may float or sink in water. And the same glass I am showing you here, a cover is on the top, okay, on the top. So it is an example of floating. It is floating means if the object is on the surface of water, then it means it is floating. And I'm taking another example, coin, 1 rupee coin, put it, it comes into the bottom of the glass. So bottom of the glass, so if it is under the glass, then it is no under the surface, then it is known as sink. Okay, sink. Then next about the definitions. Float means stay on the surface, sink means go down under the surface of water. So examples are paper and coin. Then next is about number 5th property. We have transparency. Look at all these figures. Aap teenon figure ko dekho. Pehla figure, the person, we are not able to see the face of the person. Second figure, aapko thoda thoda person ka face dikh raha hai. Third means it is almost it is visible. It is totally visible. Third wale figure mein. To aapke paas jahan pe aapko pura dikhta hai, it is known as ट्रांसपेरेंट. जहाँ पे आपको कुछ नहीं दिखता है, इसका मतलब वो हो गया ओपेक. जहाँ पे थोड़ा थोड़ा दिखता है, उसको आप क्या कहते हैं, ट्रांसलूसेंट. So here, transparent definition is materials through which things can be seen. Transparent, glass, water, air, plastics, example. Then opaque. Opaque means materials through which things cannot be seen. Example, wood, cardboard, metals. Then translucent, materials through which objects can be seen but not clear. What not clear? That means oily paper. Example is there. Then topic number third is why do we need to group materials. मतलब हमको ऐसा क्या ज़रूरत पड़ गया कि सारे materials को हम एक जगह मतलब sorting हम उसको एक जगह collect करके रखते हैं. like आपने shopkeeper के पास देखा होगा, shopkeeper के पास सारे biscuit chocolates एक जगह रखा रहता है, तो इसकी क्या ज़रूरत हो गई. So here is the necessity we group materials for our convenience. It is very easy for us that if someone asks something, okay, then if all materials are present there, then we can provide the respective material to that person. इसी को हम दूसरे शब्दों में कह सकते हैं, like अगर सारे चॉकलेट एक शॉपकीपर के पास सारे चॉकलेट्स एक जगह हैं, तो अगर कोई बच्चा उससे चॉकलेट मांगता है तो उसको वहाँ से चॉकलेट देने में आसानी हो जाएगी. so it is for our convenience, हमारी सहूलियत के लिए हम materials को एक जगह कलेक्ट करके रखते हैं. एंड नंबर सेकेंड पॉइंट इज डिवाइडिंग मटेरियल्स इनटू ग्रुप्स मेक इट कन्वीनियंट टू स्टडी देयर प्रॉपर्टीज एंड ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व एनी पैटर्न्स इन दिस प्रॉपर्टीज. सो अगेन इट इज मेकिंग अवर वर्क कन्वीनियंट फॉर प्रॉपर स्टडी ऑफ देयर प्रॉपर्टीज एज वेल एज टू स्टडी देयर पैटर्न्स. द नेक्स्ट इज अबाउट कीवर्ड्स. ये सारे हमने हार्ड इंसॉल्युबल लास्टर मटेरियल्स मेटल्स ये सारे हमने देख लिया. देन ओपेक रफ ट्रांसपेरेंट ट्रांसलूसेंट ये भी हम पढ़ चुके हैं. ये चैप्टर आपको अच्छी तरीके से समझ में आ गया होगा. इफ़ देर इज़ एनी क्वेरी देन यू कैन आस्क इन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप. थैंक यू.